welcome to Notice Tonight, the show that decodes the region. I am Wasbir Hussain. Most of us in the Northeast have always wondered why our region does not find a mention in our national anthem. We have also been thinking it would have been so nice to hear a word denoting our region in the anthem penned by the great Rabindranath Tagore in 1911. Therefore, when Congress MP from Assam, Ripun Bora, moved a private member's resolution under Rajya Sabha last week seeking an amendment of the national anthem and replaced the word Sindh with that of Uttar Purv or the Northeast, it was generally welcomed by most people in the region. Several questions arise. Can we amend the national anthem? Will the Narendra Modi government that has attached so much of importance to the Northeast agree to replace Sindh, which is actually in Pakistan now, with the word Uttar Purv? If this happens, will it bring the Northeast more closer to mainland India? We shall seek answers, but if former President Dr. Rajendra Prasad's statement of January 24, 1950 is to be taken into account, we can perhaps amend the words of our national anthem. Dr. Rajendra Prasad had said, "The composition consisting of the words and music known as Jana Gana Mana is the national anthem of India, subject to such alterations in the words as the government of India may authorize as occasion arises." Before we begin the discussion, let us listen in to what Congress MP Ripun Bora and some others had to say on the issue.
1911 চনত যেতিয়া ৰাষ্ট্ৰীয় সংগীত কম্পোজ কৰিছিল ৰবীন্দ্ৰনাথ ঠাকুৰে তেতিয়া তেখেতে হয়তো কল্পনা কৰিব পৰা নাছিল যে সময়ত যে ভাৰতবৰ্ষ বিভাজন হ'ব এই কথাটো তেখেতে কল্পনা কৰিব পৰা নাছিল গতিকে তেখেতে সেই কাৰণে সেইটো সময়ত তেখেতে যেটো গীত ৰচনা কৰিলে আমাৰ ৰাষ্ট্ৰীয় সংগীত হ'ল কিন্তু পৰৱৰ্তী কালত দেখা গ'ল যে আজি তাত সিন্ধুৰ কথা উল্লেখ কৰিছে সিন্ধু প্ৰদেশ গতিকে পঞ্জাৱ সিন্ধু কিন্তু সিন্ধু প্ৰদেশ বৰ্তমান আমাৰ ভাৰতবৰ্ষৰ লগত নাই এ পাকিস্তান আৰু এখন হস্টাইল কান্ট্রি আমাৰ এখন হস্টাইল কান্ট্রি কিন্তু আজি আমি ৰাষ্ট্ৰীয় সংগীতৰ যুগেদি আমাৰ এখন হস্টাইল কান্ট্রিক আমি সদায় নমস্কাৰ কৰি আছো কিন্তু তাৰ পৰিৱৰ্তে আমাৰ উত্তৰ পূৰ্বাঞ্চল মই অকল অসম বুলি নকওঁ আমাৰ গোটেই উত্তৰ পূৰ্বাঞ্চলৰ নাম নাই আৰু উত্তৰ পূৰ্বাঞ্চলটো হৈছে গোটেই ভাৰতবৰ্ষৰ এটা অতি সেনসিটিভ আৰু এটা অতি গুৰুত্বপূৰ্ণ এটা অংগ সবপিনৰ পৰা গতিকে সেইকাৰণে এই ৰাষ্ট্ৰীয় সংগীতত উত্তৰ পূৰ্বৰ নাম উল্লেখ কৰিব লাগে সিন্ধুৰ পৰিৱৰ্তে উত্তৰ পূৰ্বৰ নাম সন্নিৱিষ্ট হ'ব লাগে আৰু 1950 চনৰ 24 জানুৱাৰীত যেতিয়া কনষ্টিটুৱেণ্ট এছেম্বলিত এই ৰাষ্ট্ৰীয় সংগীত যেতিয়া গৃহীত হৈছিল তেতিয়া ৰাষ্ট্ৰপতি ডক্টৰ ৰাজেন্দ্ৰ প্ৰসাদে ইয়াত এইটো উল্লেখ কৰিছে যে প্ৰয়োজন হ'লে চৰকাৰে ইয়াৰ মিউজিক ইয়াৰ ৱৰ্ডিং সাল সলনি কৰিব পাৰে গতিকে যিহেতু তেতিয়াই এইটো কনষ্টিটুৱেণ্ট এছেম্বলিত গৃহীত হৈ আছে গতিকে সেই ভিত্তিত এইটো এতিয়া সাল সলনি কৰিবৰ কাৰণে মই ভাৰত চৰকাৰৰ দৃষ্টি আকৰ্ষণ কৰিছোঁ দাবী জনাইছোঁ প্ৰাইভেট মেম্বাৰ ৰিজলিউশ্যনৰ যোগেদি হিন্দুৰ নামটো উঠাই তাৰ ঠাইত উত্তৰ পূবৰ নাম সংযোগ কৰিব লাগে
Because since independence, what we are getting from the Delhi, we are getting political injustice and economic exploitation since independence. And we had expressed our resentment. And without movement, we are not getting anything to protect the identity of the state and the indigenous people of Assam for language. As the name of Assam and Northeast was missing in the national anthem, it was an insult to the people of Assam and Northeast. So it's the duty of the national leaders to decide whether they want Assam and Northeast with the rest of the country or not?
Definitely. Sindh, now Sindh is located in Pakistan. And the Northeast is an integral part of the nation. Therefore, inclusion of the Northeast, Northeast related terminology or term, that is very important in the national anthem. Because we save the pride of the country as a whole against the invasion of the Mughals. That is the important point. That is the important point for the nation. Therefore, terminology or terms should be included in the national anthem, which is related to the North.
Okay. To discuss this issue, I am joined from New Delhi by the man himself, Congress MP Ripun Bora, who is also the president of the Assam Pradesh Congress Committee. BJP General Secretary from Arunachal Pradesh, Jarpum Gamling, is in Itanagar. Besides, of course, a group of students from the Cotton University. And of course, at our studios in Guwahati, I have BJP leader Siddhartha Bhattacharjee, Ms. Asomi Dr. Barua, social entrepreneur and a leading media consultant, and Mr. Mayur Bora, writer and commentator. I'd like to go straight to you, Mr. Ripun Bora. What thoughts crossed your mind when you actually moved this private member's resolution? What do you expect the Narendra Modi to do right now?
Mr. Wasbir, first of all, I tell you, this transpired me recently. I want to quote that in 2016, 13 November, the Supreme Court of India has passed one order. While the this national anthem was made compulsory in the cinema hall, that time giving the verdict, the Supreme Court did give order, and it is mentioned that, I am quoting from that national anthem must be played before movies in theaters in order to instill committed patriotism and nationalism. Now you see, the committed patriotism and nationalism. Now question is arise for the people of Northeast region. When they will sing the national anthem, then where in their minds there will be nationalism and patriotism? When they will not find, every day they will sing the national anthem, every government function, every now and then, but they never get the opportunity to mention the name of their motherland, the name of their motherland. So how patriotism will come to their mind, how nationalism will come to their mind? They will feel neglected, they will feel deprived. So from that point of view, I thought, and during when my student life also, in our university days also, we have discussed among our class and in many places that the name of that time, the name of Assam, the Northeast, not included here. And when I gone through the proceedings of the parliament and Rajya Sabha, and then I find that in 24 January 1950, the day when this national anthem was accepted in the Constituent Assembly, that time the President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, he made himself this comment that when the situation arises,
it can
the
be
government
changed.
Can change even the music and the words.
Absolutely.
It can recompose. So it can I recompose. Will, so on that basis, I thought that it is a great injustice to the people
right,
of
and you
Northeast
moved the resolution.
India,
now, Mr. Ripun Bora,
in the freedom struggle of India.
Right. Now, Mr. Ripun Bora, do you expect the central government to act on your plea? Do you expect the central government to consider your demand favorably?
Yes. I expect it. I am totally optimistic because this is, in this thing, there is no question of any politics.
Absolutely.
I think cutting across the party political line, everybody should support, and BJP should also come forward to support, because BJP, Narendra Modi, Prime Minister, always he speaks very high of Northeast. He always speaks that he wants to make Northeast the model state, the model area of this country. He always speaks this. So now the time has come. Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
Mr. Ripun Bora, hold your thoughts, please. Mr. Siddharth Bhattacharjee, your quick comments on this
now
issue.
Now the time has come to translate into reality
the time has come
of Narendra Modi.
I agree
and
with
my
you.
My point is, you see,
let us take a quick reaction. Let me take a quick reaction from Siddharth Bhattacharjee, who is in our studios, the former BJP president, now a party MLA. Yes, sir. Siddharth, what do you have to say? Quick comments, opening remarks.
If the word Sindh is replaced by Uttar Pub, there is absolutely nothing wrong. In fact, it will be doing justice to a region which is in the focus of national attention now. And BJP, you will kindly remember, has always been trying to correct historic errors. We gave Bharat Ratna to Gopinath Bordoloi. We have named the international airport at Guwahati in his name.
Let us not go into that right now.
What I am trying to establish is that BJP has always been trying to correct historical mistakes that had been committed by
Mr. Siddhartha Bacharjee is essentially saying, Mr. Ripun Bora, is that this is something which will be good for the northeastern region, and the BJP has no problem in actually backing this idea. This is his personal opinion. Let me quickly also go to Jarpum Gamling, who is the BJP General Secretary in Arunachal Pradesh. Jarpum, welcome. How do you look at this demand? This is not a Congress versus BJP issue, but it was raised by the Congress MP, Mr. Ripun Bora. How are you looking at this demand that the word Sindh in the national anthem be replaced by Uttar Purv or some other word to denote the region, northeast? Jarpum.
In fact, I welcome the demand that Uttar Purv should be included, because we are part and parcel of Indian geography and Indian constitution. But if you are saying that it should be replaced, then, you know, I do have philosophical differences with the terms of replacement, because main nahi samajhta hu ki kuch cheez ko jodna ho to wahan se kisi ko nikalna anivarya hai. Number 1. Number 2, jahan tak Sindh ka sawal hai, ye kehkar ki Sindh jo province hai wo Pakistan chale gaye hain, to mere khayal se wo jisne bhi demand rakha hai unke samajh mein kuch kamiyan reh gaya hai, kyunki Sindh केवल सिंध प्रोविंस को डिनोट नहीं करता है, वो एक हमारे अभिन्न अंग है भारत का, जो हमारे नदी है उसको डिनोट करता है, जो आज भी भारतीय भूगोल के अंदर ही है. तो मैं समझता हूँ कि पूर्वोत्तर को जरूर इंक्लूड करना चाहिए, मगर ये कहकर कि सिंध को हटा के करना है, ये मेरे ख्याल से दिस इज अ मिसप्लेस्ड थॉट एंड आइडिया. मैं सपोर्ट करता हूँ कि पूर्वोत्तर को इंक्लूड करना है, मगर सिंध को रिप्लेस ना करें.
So very interesting argument there, Ripun Bora. I'll come to my panelists in the studio, but Mr. Ripun Bora, there's a very interesting argument by Jarpum Gamling, the young general secretary of the BJP in Arunachal Pradesh. He's saying that Sindh ko replace na kare, lekin purbottar sab jarur include kare. That is what it is assessment saying, that no need to replace Sindh, but yes, not the word northeast or Uttar Purv should be included. How do you look at this very interesting argument?
No, that is of course, that is in a sense he is correct. But my point is this, you see, this Indus, originally its name was Indus, and in Sanskrit it is called as Sindhu, and in English it is called as Sindh. Now, this Sindh is, Rabindranath Tagore tried to meaning it as the Sindh area, Sindh province. Now this entire Sindh province is in Pakistan. So river, so far he said about the river. The river is the national river of Pakistan now. This, though it is all right, at one time when we were undivided, and at the time of prehistoric age,
then though Indus Valley
civilization is grown up at that in that area, that is all right. That is no dispute at all. But so far after partition, what happened? The entire Sindh, it has gone to Pakistan, and the Sindh River, only it originates from Mansarovar and touches only a small part of Ladakh in Kashmir area. Entire the other part is in the Pakistan. So it is the national river of Pakistan. So my point is that in the national anthem, we salute the countries, we salute the states, we salute India, the parts of India. Now my question is, what is the justification of saluting
point
Sindh,
noted.
Who is hostile
point,
to our
point
country?
Noted. Point
Pakistan
noted,
is
Mr. Ripun Bora.
You see, point, hostile to our country.
Point noted.
So I
Let
do
me
not
quickly,
find any justification
yes,
of...
Absolutely. Point noted. I will have to take the opening remarks of two of my panelists who have not spoken yet. Quickly to the group of young boys and girls at Cotton University, my correspondent Srijit Banerjee is there at the Cotton University. Srijit, I understand you have a group of students with you. What do they think about this issue, about the national anthem, about the Northeast finding a mention in the national anthem and replacing of the word Sindh, which is now in Pakistan?
Yes, I have a few students with me over here. So you are aware of the recent topic about the national anthem debate, where the replacement for the word sin with Northeast has been proposed. So what is your take on it? What do you think? Like, should there be a replacement or should there be something else to include Northeast?
First of all, I would like to say that yes, there are two things. First of being a Northeast Indian or a state of citizens of Assam, we need that there should be a replacement of the word sin. On the other hand, the national anthem is a creation of a intellectual person, Rabindranath Tagore. On the other hand, we don't want to actually disrespect his creation. And even we can say that yes, there should be that we have feel disrespected. Why there is not there the name of Northeast India or any other like the river Brahmaputra? Yes, there. But on the other hand, the Tagore has written such a great poem. Tagore himself said that he hadn't written the poem on the occasion or the theme or the motivation of for the national anthem. But he wrote as a poem which was actually initiated
later,
as
later.
On the first session of the Congress
election
at the Kolkata session. Therefore,
right.
He had
can you go to another student's views?
It will be a national anthem on the later India.
Right.
Joined by a young man over here who actually wrote a letter to the Prime Minister last year proposing to include Northeast in the national anthem. So we'll try to get his view. So tell us about the thing that you wrote a letter to Prime Minister, and what's your take on the replacement for the word sin in
yes.
the national anthem?
Yes, thank you. Last year on 14 August 2017, I wrote a letter to the Prime Minister of India requesting him to scrutinize the national anthem of India if we can include our Northeast or the river Brahmaputra as a whole to represent Northeast India in the national anthem of India, so that the future generations and the present generation of the country can identify the Northeast part of the country. And in this case, with the replacement of Sindh with Northeast, I would like to say that yes, one of my friends has already said that we don't want to disrespect the beautiful and the great creation of Rabindranath Tagore, because and it has been our national anthem since the time of independence. So in order to include Northeast, we can also include the word Brahmaputra or the Northeast.
Okay, we'll come to that. Srijit, hold on. Srijit, hold your thoughts. Ohomiratta Borua, nobody is talking about the fact that in 1911, when Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore wrote this poem or wrote this song, you know, Northeast was a part of the Greater Bengal.
Yes.
Nobody is, so perhaps he thought, that he has already included Bongo, so that includes the entire Northeast. Do you think that can also be an argument? Of course, there is no denying the fact that since Rajendra Prasad has already said in his January 1950 statement that Government of India can change according to the need, as and when the need arises. But now, yes, 70 years after independence, I think Northeast should have found mention. The anthem could have been amended. So what are your thoughts?
You're absolutely right, Wasbir. The fact is that history has placed us in a very, you know, interesting position as
yeah.
far as Northeast is concerned. If you look at Northeast today, or what we call Uttar Purv, there were two states like Tripura, or three in fact, Sikkim, Tripura and Manipur. They were separate countries, right?
Yes.
And there were states like Assam, which included Nepha, Nagaland, Mizoram and all of that, which was one big composite Greater Assam. And that was in fact a part of Bengal, and in fact Sylhet was a very important part of that entire geographical
entity. Yes.
So when Rabindranath Tagore, when he wrote that poem, it some people say that actually, you know, which I have just found out, is that it was actually written in honor of the King of England and his wife, who were actually coming.
Well,
to,
that is
so
a
that,
debatable issue,
okay,
whether or not he wrote
anyway,
it in honor of the
so
king. That is a different issue,
yeah, but
and a debatable one at that.
Yes, but eventually what happened is that in the course of history, we also know that this poem, the first five stanzas of this poem, was in fact adopted in 1950
That's
as
right.
the national anthem.
Absolutely.
But having said that, one very important point remains is that in the larger perspective of the Indian consciousness, Uttar Purv or Northeast has always been sidelined.
And so that means essentially, I'll come back to you. Essentially, you are supporting this demand that
yes.
the word Northeast or something to denote the region must be included in the national anthem.
Yes.
Mohir Bora, how are you looking at it? Do you have a different perspective on this, or do you flow with the tide?
No, I'd love to flow with the tide, but I think as a student of history, we have to remember that Ripun Bora has highlighted that 24 January 1950 is a very important date. Because Mr. Bora, just hold on. And great to see two politicians today speaking more or less in the same language. Oh, I think that's why he is so excited. What I want to say, 1st July 1948, when All India Radio Station and Shillong was inaugurated, at that time itself, there is a big hue and cry under the leadership of Keshav Narayan Dutta, and they said that we will sing Bande Mataram instead of Janagana Mana. Thereafter, the first appointed, Indian appointed governor of Assam, Akbar Haidari, he wrote to Nehru, there is a need to change the nomenclature of this particular anthem. And if you see the acclaimed works of Professor Udayan Mishra, you will find, and Dr. Nirod Boruas, you will find adequate mention about that. But today what I mean to say, in the context of some of the young friends are telling that we cannot replace it, we should add this particular word, I think that the rhythmic tone of singing of the song will be distorted.
That is,
and
a different channel. That is
different
a different
channel.
Challenge.
No, but Wasbir, we have to keep in mind the fact that
but long and short of the story, Mohir, are you supporting the idea or not? Don't you think that the Northeast in today's context,
I am 100%
70 years of independence, we need to have our Northeast in the national anthem.
Supporting the idea 100% that although it is symbolic,
we'll
this symbolism is important.
Symbolism is important.
Yeah.
Ripun Bora, you were saying something. I'll come to you, Siddharth Bhattacharjee. Yes, Ripun Bora.
Yes. No. I nothing want to dispute with Asami Dutta Borua. Only I want to supplement one thing. They so far Bongo is, yes, she is very correct. When the Rabindranath Tagore composed this, that time it is called Bongo is a big region. The entire Northeast region is also there, and the East Pakistan is also with that. Now it is in Bangladesh. Now
yes.
It is Bangladesh. Now our question is, after this East Pakistan is no longer. It is Bongo. East Pakistan is no longer. It has become now Bangladesh. Now Bongo we mean only West Bengal. Now Bongo as on today,
context
we mean
has
only
changed.
West Bengal.
Absolutely.
So from that point of view also, we have every reason to believe.
Correct.
We have every reason to believe that Bongo, West Bengal's name is there, but the
Noted.
People of Northeastern region, the name of
Noted.
Northeast region is not there.
Very
so
well
this
said.
Is also
point
one
noted.
Of the,
Ripun Bora, point noted.
This thing.
Point noted. Very valid
well,
argument.
Just
a minute. Let me quickly bring in Siddharth Bhattacharjee. I have to go for a short break. Siddharth Bhattacharjee, I think there is sense in this argument, isn't it? Whoever is making this argument, and in this case, Ripun Bora is making this argument, that fine, it was a part of Bengal when Rabindranath Tagore wrote this poem or song, but today it's a completely different geographical entity, and therefore a Northeast must find mention.
I mean, as I have said earlier,
yeah.
There is absolutely nothing wrong in replacing a word in the national anthem, because Dr. Rajendra Prasad has, right at the time when it was being adopted as the national anthem of India, had clearly stated
as the president yes,
it was basically passed in the Constituent Assembly, not in Parliament. When geographical, political and other issues change, we have made so many amendments to the Constitution.
Yes.
National anthem is a part and parcel of the Indian Constitution.
So why not? Why can't it be changed?
Why not?
Very good argument there. If the constitution has been amended, I will go for a bit. But before that, very quickly, Jarpal Gamlin, आपका कहना है कि सिंधु शब्द के साथ आपको कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, लेकिन उत्तर पूर्व को उसमें डालना चाहिए. यही, this is your basic argument, isn't it, Jarpal Gamlin?
बिल्कुल. Because उत्तर पूर्व include होना है, ये मैं मानता हूँ. क्योंकि राष्ट्रगीत में, बिकॉज आज भी राष्ट्रगीत को जिस तरह यहाँ लोग एक पैट्रियटिज्म के साथ, एक नेशनलिस्टिक फीलिंग के साथ लोग जो गाते हैं, उसको देखते हुए, और कि एक एलियनेटेड पार्ट है जो हम मार्जिन में है, तो उसको अंदर लाना है, तो राष्ट्रगीत में हमको इंक्लूड करना है, ये बहुत अच्छा डिमांड है.
Absolutely. On this note, I'll come back to Srijit. Please tell your guest to hold on. I'll go for a short break. Stay on. We'll be right back on this program. Welcome back to Northeast Tonight. Srijit Banerjee, I'd like to go to our correspondent, Srijit. Srijit, do you think, you know, the inclusion, I think we have lost Srijit there. Ripun Bora, you know, you have made this demand, you have moved the private members resolution. Generally, you have been welcomed by everybody. Now, my question to you, do you think that once this word is included, this will add to the patriotic fervor already existing? I'm not saying there is no patriotic fervor in the Northeast. Do you think it will add to the already existing patriotism or patriotic fervor among the people of the Northeast?
No, you see, it is, of course, you are correct. There is, we do not say that we beat the people, we never say that because of not mentioning of this name Northeast, we are not patriotic, we are not nationalism. But you see, the history, for the history, for our next generation also, there is perception that everybody, when their contribution, their sacrifices, if it is recognized, everybody is pleased, everybody, it is required to give due respect. Now you see, the national anthem, what is the main theme? That it should be given due respect, equal respect to all the states, to all the castes, to all the regions of this country.
Right.
So from that point of view, the national anthem, when the name of Northeast is not there, that there is every region, the people may believe that we have not been given equal status.
Absolutely.
We have not been given equality to the rest part of the country.
Asami, Dr. Bora, not many can actually refute this argument put forward by Ripun Bora. What do you think at the new generation? Do you think it will impact on the new generation the moment Northeast is included in the national anthem? Do you think so?
Yes, to an extent I think so, because there is a kind of disconnect of many of the people in the rest of India, who we call the mainland, as far as Northeast is concerned.
Yeah.
So when a national, something like the national anthem, which is sung over and over again in schools, in colleges, in sports events, in, you know, in just everywhere, the national anthem brings you a sense of great national pride.
Absolutely.
And it's only when you keep on repeating a certain word that reflects somewhere.
Let me take a view of this. I'll come back to you. I'm sorry about that. Srijit, you know, this question goes to your young guests. Do you think, you know, whenever we see the national flag being raised at a sports stadium anywhere in the country or outside, you know, the sense of pride goes, I mean, high, you know, in every Indian. So do you think the inclusion of the Northeast as part of the national anthem, do you think it'll enthuse or add to the patriotic fervor among the younger generation of people in the Northeast?
Right, a very good question. So the question for you is, like, whenever we see the national flag in high mast, during a national day or any national festival, so the sense of pride, we get a sense of pride. So when the terminology relating to Northeast, if it's included in the national anthem, how much pride will it be for you as a young man from the Northeast?
Actually, the national anthem, it's my personal opinion, I think, that the national anthem, it reflects India as a whole. Even though the word Northeast is presently there or not, I still feel that same pride, because it reflects India, that is Bharat as a whole, and I feel Indian as a whole. But most importantly, if in future we can have this amendment, I will be very happy. When we see the national anthem, it reflects the entire India as a whole, and a common identity, that is Indianness.
Yes. So the same question for you, like, whenever you see the national flag up high, you feel the sense of pride. So if a terminology relating to Northeast is included in the anthem, how will it be for you as a young boy from Northeast?
Exactly, the situation is such right now, what is happening, that we could see that we could have a sense of fear that we are not getting included in the national anthem. If that is creating some sort of sense of fear within the minds of each of the people, those who are residing in Northeast, then definitely there is a problem. The first thing that I would like to say, if there is a sense of fear, that means there is a problem. So if this problem can be solved, if we could have a better solution to this problem where the terminology can be added, from the northeast, whether it be Brahmaputra or whatever so far. I am not sure about the terminology because I don't have that instinct. But the thing is that if you can add the particular terminology, then definitely I believe that the sense of patriotic feeling that we can have by seeing the national flag,
right.
The sense of patriotism that I feel, that will be felt by each and every people residing over in the north, because almost we feel disconnected,
yes,
from the entire India part. Though we talk about the entire people of India, I'll come back to you,
Moyur Bora. I mean, one of the boys, these are all students of Cotton University, very interesting views there. One of them said that although the Northeast doesn't figure in the national anthem as it stands today, I mean, he feels the same sense of pride because that actually denotes Indianness, that signifies Indianness, the idea of India.
Yeah.
Moyur.
I told in the beginning itself that it's a very symbolic thing, but that symbolism is very, very important. I think he is entitled to his own opinion. The young man, he said that without that being included also, he will feel, and we all feel as Indian as we are feeling now.
Yeah.
But we have to keep in mind two contexts. First of all, only during last month, we know in Canada, the national anthem has been changed. It has been made more gender neutral. Instead of sons, they have made it in all of us command. So that's an important point. This
very
is also
point.
In pursuance of a private members bill as proposed by Mr. Ripun Bora. And number two, another historical argument being propounded by some of the panelists here, actually there is some correction required, because when you say that Rabindranath Tagore wrote this thinking that Assam is part of Bongo, Assam in 1874 became a separate commissioner's province along with Sylhet district of now Bangladesh. Secondly, when 1905 Lord Curzon bifurcated the partition of Bengal, thereafter also Assam was part of East Bengal.
Yeah.
It was never part of West Bengal, in whose soil Rabindranath Tagore wrote this song. I think this historical fallacy
also,
and inaccuracy needs to be countered.
Also has to be taken into account. Jarpum Gamlin, I'll come to you, Siddharth Bhattacharji. Jarpum Gamlin, do you think that now everyone, all political parties must unite to make this demand that, some word has to be included in the national anthem to denote the Northeastern Indian, although it is 70 years have passed since we attained independence? Jarpum.
Bilkul. Main samajhta hun ki we should rise above the petty politics or electoral politics, and we should not see it as a political agenda. But it should be seen as agenda to integrate the country, and in that direction, I think it would be a very, very good initiative that all political parties should come together.
Now, another question to you, Jarpum. As you know, you are with the BJP. Do you think that the Narendra Modi government now should come forward to accept this demand sooner than later, because his government has been attaching so much of importance to the Northeastern region? In fact, after all, it's just replacing one word or keeping that word, as you said, and adding another word to denote the Northeast. Jarpum.
Absolutely. I think if you have seen, I think Modi government has brought the South Bloc and North Bloc to Northeast India by ensuring that a union minister travels to this part of the world every 15 days. And Narendra Modi himself, after becoming Prime Minister, I think he has traveled almost 19 times to this part of the country. I think this is unprecedented. And given his idea of a unified India and of a balanced, equitable growth of economy across the country, I think, this would bring in a lot of comfort to the people of Northeast, which has been neglected for far too long. And insofar as the debate is concerned, I think to say that Northeast is not included is absolutely also would be historically incorrect, because I think if we go through the history of the song of the national anthem, I think 1911, if I'm right.
That is what we are discussing, yes.
That at that point in time, I think we were part of the
Bengal
frontier. So therefore, I think, one way of saying that we are not included, I think it's also misplaced, because historical perspective needs to be kept in mind.
He didn't get it. We are not part of West Bengal. We are part of West Bengal.
Let him say that we are not included. But at that point in time, we are included. But you are also right, and Mr. Bora is also right in demanding that we should be included now, because with time we should move on, with time we should evolve, we should modify ourselves. I think it's a great demand.
Right. Mr. No, Siddharth, just a minute, Mr. Siddharth, I'll come to you, Moyur. Mr. Siddharth Bhattacharjee, today, are you ready to assure Mr. Ripun Bora, otherwise belonging to a different political party, that you are one with him as far as the interest of the Northeast is concerned, that as your colleague from Arunachal Pradesh, Jarpum, has said, that we should rise above petty politics on this issue and we should talk about the interest of the Northeastern region? Why not? Let us have our name included in the national anthem. It will add to our pride.
Mr. Bora has raised a private member's bill, and there are certain procedures and technicalities involved in parliament. But if you talk of including the word Uttar Pub, I have absolutely no hesitation whatsoever in including that. And secondly, I feel that we always have to move ahead. Like Mr. Moyur has said, in Canada, they become more gender
neutral.
And they have, instead of sons, they have converted it into a neutral word, us. I think in India also, because so much of importance is being given to Northeast now, you will appreciate that earlier also there was a big grudge, there was a big heartburn among Assamese people that Gopinath Bordoloi was never given his due recognition. And when Bajpayee ji became the prime minister, the first thing he did was to give a recognition of Bharat Ratna to Gopinath Bordoloi ji. So I feel, and because a few days back also, when Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji came to Manipur, he again reiterated the fact that Northeast is going to be the engine of progress of India. So, to bring in a symbolic gesture,
should not be a problem.
It should not be a problem.
Absolutely. Mr. Ripun Bora, I must ask you this question. Why is it that, you know, your party was also in power till 3 years ago or 3.5 years ago? The UPA was running the country for 10 years. My question to you, Mr. Ripun Bora, why is it that, you know, we in the Northeastern region always have to demand or agitate for basic things which is actually our due? Isn't it? For a refinery, you have to agitate. For a language, you have to agitate. Now, you have to place a demand, in this case, private members' resolution to include the Northeast in the national anthem. Why does things not come naturally, automatically? What do you think? Let's not politicize. I'm not politicizing it. I'm just asking, as a senior leader,
yes,
I need your views.
No, Wasbir, in the very beginning also, I said that I have raised this private member resolution cutting across the party line.
Yeah.
I do not want to make it politicized, and nobody should make it politicized. So that's why I beginning at this said that I am very optimistic that the BJP and the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi will also support this, as he always spoke very high up Northeast region every here and there.
Yeah.
And he wants to be make Northeast region as the hub of India. So so from that point of view, I also appeal to all. Now my question is this. This is whether it is Congress party, whether it is BJP party, or whether any other national party, it is a very unfortunate that there is a something communication gap. Something communication gap, either this or that, they do not want to correctly understand. They do not want to correctly understand the Northeast region. So because of that, and sometimes it is correct that our leaders, we also sometimes have failed to assert and to give the clear picture or to convince the national leaders about the interest,
absolutely,
about the causes, about the
Ripun Bora, I must say that I am extremely
also. That thing is there.
I must say that I am extremely happy today to hear such candid assessments, self-introspection by a senior leader like you. Let me take Asami Dr. Borua. Isn't it nice to hear political leaders self-introspect on issues concerning the Northeast and their own role?
Absolutely, Wasbir. In fact, you know, every time that we've spoken about these things in private, in the drawing room or wherever we have, you know, we need to talk about Northeast,
yeah,
we've always felt that why is it that the members of parliament from Northeast
all
don't
come together.
Speak about issues which are important for the region and for certain reason subjects, you know, there's no need to go into the party mold.
Yes.
We just can, you know, talk about those issues strongly in one voice in the forum, and that somehow never comes about.
Excellent point. Excellent point made by Homi Dr. Bora Moyor. It could not have been more better said. We have got only 25 MPs. We always do politics, that's fine. But when it comes to the interest of the Northeast, I think we have tried this before, but it did not click. But do you think there is still time that we speak in one voice about issues concerning the Northeastern region?
Moyor. I think this can be the beginning. Better late than never. I am an optimist. I am robustly optimist. So I believe whatever initiative has been taken by Mr. Ripun Bora and as has been endorsed by Siddhartha Bhattacharya in this studio,
yes,
I think can go very well in including the name of Northeast, and it has been enabled by what first president of the country has uttered on 24 January 1950 and what has happened recently in Canada. But another aspect, Wasbir, since it is pertains to history, let me tell you, and this is in the recorded history of the conversation between one of the icons of Assamese literature, Lakshminath Besbarua, who was married into the family of Rabindranath Tagore. I have got highest regard for Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore wrote a poem eulogizing the Saint Shankardev. We are grateful to him. But he had a patronizing attitude towards Assamese as well as Uriya. He told Lakshminath Besbarua, because of your hesitation to make Assamese language as a flowery kind of a language, as a robust language, the sale of the Bengali books have come down. This is a recorded history. So I think his mindset also needs to be accounted. He is also a flesh and blood man. Mm-hmm. Whatever mistakes, if at all, he has committed, without inadequately or insufficiently thinking about the sensitivities of the people from Northeast, that needs to be corrected now, and we all should be united in this demand.
Absolutely. I mean, that is a different aspect which you are saying,
but I think important.
But on this point, Siddhartha Bhattacharya, do you think that this episode can be a beginning? Yes, we have enough issues to do politics on. We have enough issues to try to pull each other down. But on issues concerning the Northeast, on neutral issues like this concerning nothing but the interest of the Northeast, do you think political parties must unite? Better late than never.
A initiative has already been made. There is a forum of Northeast member of parliaments in Delhi.
We have heard about it from the last 3 decades.
And they are often, you know, like sitting and discussing issues common to Northeast. Secondly, we have to appreciate one thing. Before we go and criticize a historic figure, we also have to accept the mindset of the period in which he lived. Today's mindset, definitely, there was no concept of Northeast during the time of Rabindranath Tagore. So, if we want to place the mindset of an individual belonging to the 19th century in today's context, obviously, it will not tally. So, it will be wrong to. You will allow me to complete. I think to put the perception of an individual in today's context will obviously be not correct.
Okay. Let me quickly.
I am not taking his in today's context. That is why I said I am eternally grateful to him for penning down a beautiful eulogy in the name of Shankardev. And this is recorded between Lakshminath Besbarua. Will you amount to criticizing Lakshminath Besbarua also, who took the cudgels? This is important also.
No doubt that it is important.
I want to supplement.
Yes, carry on. I like to go to my correspondent Srijit, who has these young boys and girls with him. Yes, supplement. Yes, Ripun Bora. Yes, carry on, please, quickly. Yes,
so actually, I want to supplement only this thing. This just now you have already, you see so far this communication gap among the leaders of Northeast region, irrespective of party. I have already said. Now it depends on the leadership. Say, as for example, you take the example of Gopinath Bordoloi. When Assam was annexed with East Bengal that time, it is Gopinath Bordoloi, he could assert it, he could convince the central leaders. And because of that, Assam has been saved from the regrouping.
Absolutely.
So similarly, in 2002, when there was the Vajpayee was the prime minister, that our Tarun Gogoi was the chief minister. Then in the NSCN ceasefire agreement, so in the NSCN ceasefire agreement, Admani has made the agreement that the ceasefire will be extended to Assam also.
But it is Tarun Gogoi who convinced Wasbir, that it will
be true,
very harmful to the Assam.
That is true,
is
but let's not go.
So I
stick
say
to
from
our
that point of. So it is we the leaders of Northeast.
Right.
I am not blaming.
Lot depends on leaders. There are issues.
Central government is concerned.
I would
whenever
not like to juxtapose
them,
issues on today, at least. Srijit, what do the young people think? My question to them. Srijit, are you there? Yes. Carry this question to them.
Yes,
symbolism
yes.
and spirit of patriotism. How important is symbolism? Like inclusion of a name, inclusion of a region.
Okay, when it comes to the inclusion of Northeast as a region or anything,
symbolism.
How symbolic it is for you?
Symbolism.
The Northeast, I think Northeast should be included to the national anthem because it really hurt our feelings. Because while singing national anthem, we feel like Indian. Yes, it's true, no doubt. But it hurts our feelings because there is no mention of Northeast, and I think it should be included, and it will be symbolized like. It's like our love, and
so
it should
it's
be.
It's
like a
message, will it?
It will be like our pride, and we
Absolutely.
Love our love. It will show our love, actually.
So what do you think?
Yes, definitely. There should be a symbolic like the inclusion of the word
yes,
Brahmaputra,
yes.
because or on the other hand, we can say that the seven sisters or the word unity that we have among our seven sisters, that should be the main symbol that that should be used in the case of the Northeast. Because on the other hand, I would like to say that if there is an exclusion of the word sin, on the other hand, if there is an inclusion of the word Northeast, that should be the whole India should feel the same vibration or same we feel the same that the rising of the goosebumps if there is a addition or the new addition of with the inclusion of Northeast or base symbolizes that either with the word Brahmaputra or the integrity and the unity of the seven sisters of Northeast.
Okay, that's a very very specific suggestion coming from that lady there. Either use the word Brahmaputra or include something the seven sisters symbolizing the entire Northeast. Siddharth Bhattacharya, you were saying something.
Basically the national flag or the national anthem,
yeah,
it is a symbol. It symbolizes the...
It itself is a symbol, biggest
it itself
symbol.
Is
biggest
a symbol,
symbol.
The biggest symbol,
yeah.
Where we get identified as one cohesive identity of Indianness.
One nation and one people.
One nation and...
one people.
And that represents the national flag. That national flag represents the whole republic as such.
Right.
Similarly, the national anthem. The national anthem is also a symbol of our Indianness.
Absolutely.
And I feel, obviously,
yeah.
Adding the word Uttar Pub will give more truth to the
whole idea.
Whole idea.
Jarpum Gamlim, symbolism and spirit of patriotism. Is there a link there? Symbolism and the spirit of patriotism, the linkage, Jarpum.
Absolutely, I think not add, it will take us to a different level altogether. Because even today, despite being so committed to the constitution of India, I think, you know, there are simmering tension in the state like Manipur or Nagaland, you know, there are demands of separate state. So from that perspective, I think it's important that, you know, Northeast should be included. I think from that angle, I'm saying that it is very, very important and pertinent at this point in time.
Very, very important,
rightly
I'll
you pointed out
your...
70 years in independence, there is still a demand for separate state. I think if we have to dissolve these kinds of demand at some point in time and in somewhere constitutionally, I think editing our national anthem would be a great step forward.
Right. Very important point made by Jarpum there that despite this whole thing of patriotic fervor, patriotism, patriotic spirit, there are different elements of subnationalism or right to self-determination demands, various kinds of demands in the Northeastern region. So it is extremely important to add to this whole spirit of nationalism or patriotism by including or something, some word denoting the Northeast into our national anthem. We'll go for another short break. Stay on. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Ripun Bora, now what is your next step? Are you in touch with leaders of other political parties on this issue, seeking their support or gathering people to lobby your cause?
Yes, I have already started lobbying and contacting with the different leaders of the different political parties in the parliament. I have made an appeal to them, and almost so far during these few days, 3-4 days, whatever I interacted with them, everybody is very positive and everybody is supporting this. Everybody is positive. So from that point of view, right. I think that cutting across the party line, all the members of parliament will support when the matter will come for discussion in the parliament.
Absolutely. Ohomid Ottoborua, do you think, you know, we should not confine this whole initiative to only this national anthem issue? It's a very good thing which has happened. Do you think this has the potential to be elaborated or made broad-based for among MPs and political leaders from within the northeastern region, MPs in Delhi, to lobby and push genuine interest of the northeast?
Absolutely, Wasbir. This has been actually the call of the day for a very, very long time. And this is the stepping stone, and I'm extremely happy to hear from our Honorable MP, Shri Ripun Bora, that he has started a dialogue across party lines with MPs from...
Now, we must also put in record that we have heard very positive comments from Siddhartha Barasarji and Jarpum Gamlin.
Yes.
Irrespective of whichever party they belong to.
Yes.
That is the point to be noted today.
Yes. And I also feel that this should be taken to a level of a national campaign where awareness is created about our issue, which actually shouldn't belong to just the Northeast. You know, the inclusion of Northeast in the national anthem is just one of the issues, but it's important enough to understand that for the rest of India and the Indians who sing the national anthem with pride,
absolutely,
they should also understand that we also have certain reservations about why we've been, you know, not part of the mainland or whatever it is. And this would be a wonderful way in which they can, by accepting this resolution or supporting it actually, mm-hmm, will actually go a long way in create removing a lot of the barriers which exist today.
Right. Siddhartha Bhattacharya, I mean, do you think this has the potential, this is just the spark, and this has the potential to be made into a broad-based movement, political movement, but all political parties in the same kind of a movement on genuine issues?
As the saying goes, better late than never.
Yeah.
If the initiative has come up, it have to be, I am taking into consideration the practical reality of getting a private member's resolution passed in parliament. It has to be broad based, it has to be non-political. Definitely the issue which has been raised, it could have been raised earlier also, never mind, I won't go into that.
Yeah.
But now that it has been raised, it should be made more broad based, and more political opinions, more political spectrum should be brought into this issue. And I think it will be very prudent.
Do you also think that some other genuine issues concerning the Northeast can also be pushed in a similar manner by different political parties?
Oh yes, obviously. People's interest is the topmost priority for anybody. Why we are in politics? We are in politics so that we can uplift the social economic condition of our state.
Mohir Bora, extremely encouraging words, isn't
encouraging
it?
Encouraging words, and I say that they are saying the same vocabulary today, all the politicians. It's a very positive development.
Yeah.
It's a beginning, but we have to make it a glorious beginning. I think the initial role has to be played by the politicians and also praise in civil society, so that whatever has been initiated by Ripun Bora today, as you have rightly pointed out, if you can in the times to come broad-base it, and all the issues concerning the real genuine interest of Northeast, if you can unite all the MPs cutting across party lines, I think our voice will be heard in the corridors of power in Delhi. I think that's
so
very important.
But
if you give me 30 seconds, I have got that young friend from Cotton University who said that Brahmaputra, okay, anyone who is in Brahmaputra Valley will be happy about that term, but Brahmaputra will not be a very inclusive term, because someone in Aizawl and Manipur may not like that. Although I appreciate the young lady for her opinion, I think Uttarpu personally, I feel, would be the more inclusive term to denote and embody the feelings of this
entire people
this region on the other side of the chicken neck.
Yes.
Now, Ripun Bora, we have got 25 MPs. Okay, you have said that you have written letters, yes, you have lobbied with other political parties, that's fine. But do you think you are now going to take some kind of an initiative to have a dialogue with all our 25 MPs, irrespective of which party they belong to, not just on this issue, but other issues? Because earlier attempts in this front has not yielded much results. We have been seeing this for the last 30 years.
Yeah, you are absolutely correct, and Mayur is also absolutely correct. Now, this is the need of the hour. For the interest of our Northeast region, we must all should unite, cutting across the party line. And so far, Siddharth Bhattacharya has, some time back, he has referred about the Northeast MPs Forum. Well, in the Northeast MPs Forum also, we cutting across the party line, we discuss so many issues, but it is very unfortunate. Sometimes, though we unitedly raise the voices, it has been not heard. As for example, that we, the Northeast Forum, we have objected that this abolition of industrial promotion policy, that is to be restored,
yeah,
that has been ignored. Similarly, the abolition of special category status to Assam and other northeastern states, that has also been not heard. This is, of course, I am not.
We will hope things improve and things change. If we can go back to Srijit, my last question to your guest: do you think the political parties should unite, forget cutting across party lines, and jointly raise genuine issues concerning the people of the Northeastern region?
Okay, so the final question is, do you think the politicians of the region, regardless to their ideological boundaries and differences, whatever, should be united and put a call in the parliament that Northeast should be included? A quick reaction from all of you.
Not just not included.
Yes, we want that, everyone should be united and should stand that there should be the name of Northeast in the Janagana Mana or the national anthem.
Yes, I also agree with that. That we should be united, everyone should be united and take a decision.
Yes, definitely they should unite together, because this is a matter of consideration, not on the political basis, but it is a concern for each and every people residing out in Northeast. So this should be an overall topic, overall concern, not for one political party. That should be not.
So first of all, I want to thank our Honorable MP for taking the initiative. But there is a sad reality from our youth. When we see the proceedings of the parliament, they are washed away, abrupted, continuously. So this is a very sad state of affairs.
Yeah.
So we don't know how far the bill will proceed.
So should the party or all the politicians should get united and raise a cause?
Yeah, there should be, and this should be above the vested interest.
Okay. Although, thank you, Srijit, thanks to your guest. Although I was asking them a general question, they brought me back to the core focus of today's discussion, that is whether the political parties should unite or whether Northeastern region has to be included in the national anthem. It has to be, of course. That brings me to Jarpum Gamlim once again. So Jarpum, the amendment to the national anthem is necessary. So there's absolutely no problem. Northeast will come much closer to the mainstream if we have the word. Do you agree to this school of thought?
मैं बिल्कुल ये मानता हूँ, क्योंकि जैसे कि मैंने अभी कहा है कि यहाँ पूर्वोत्तर, जबकि भौगोलिक तरीके से एक भारत का अभिन्न हिस्सा है, फिर भी कई जगह कुछ राज्य है जहाँ आज भी एक स्वतंत्र देश, एक राष्ट्र की जो डिमांड हो रहे हैं, जो 70 साल के बाद भी आज सॉल्व नहीं हुआ है. तो मेरे ख्याल से उस दिशा में ये बहुत बड़ा कदम होगा कि राष्ट्रगीत में हमारे पूर्वोत्तर राज्यों को भी इंक्लूड करा जाए. ये मैं नहीं कहता हूँ कि एक एक इंडिविजुअल स्टेट को करा जाए, मगर पूर्वोत्तर शब्द का इस्तेमाल किया जाए, या एक इंक्लूसिव इंक्लूजन का जो एक सिंबॉलिक जेस्चर आए, तो इससे बहुत बड़ा फर्क पड़ेगा, ये मैं मानता हूँ.
ओके, मिस्टर रिपिन बोरा, इफ यू कैन हियर मी, एज एन MP फ्रॉम असम, आर यू गोइंग टू रिक्वेस्ट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ असम एंड अदर गवर्नमेंट्स इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट टू प्लेस दिस डिमांड फॉर्मली बिफोर द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट?
Yes, why not? Definitely I will approach all the chief ministers of the northeastern states. From their side also, they should mount the pressure on the central government.
Okay.
Definitely, I will
Okay, he said that he will definitely do so. I apologize for the poor audio quality there. Mohir Bora, I mean, do you think, my question was, do you think this can lead to a broad-based kind of a movement, if I may loosely use the word?
Yeah, it can, but it all depends on one thing. I'll just take an example, just whatever has been said just 60 seconds ago. Ripun Bora said, and you asked that whether you'll be writing to all the governments in Northeast. I can take personally that today Siddhartha Bhattacharjee is present here. He is a senior leader of the party, ex-party president. So he and his friends in the party and also in the Northeast, without waiting for the letter from Ripun Bora, if they impress upon their party higher-ups at the center for this particular work, I think they will be behaving more like a statesman and less like a politician. And such an issue like that, if they behave like a statesman, I think people of the Northeast will be grateful to that.
Before I ask Siddhartha Bhattacharjee to respond, I think the Northeast has enough politicians, but very few statesmen. Are we going to see statesmen emerge out of this issue? Siddhartha Bhattacharjee.
I may sound cynical, but I hope that this move is more out of statesmanship, not out of scoring a brownie point.
So what are you saying essentially? If you can be a little more clear.
I hope and pray that the whole move is not to make a political statement, not to make a issue which will give a brownie point to somebody. Issue is definitely genuine, as you have very correctly said. We will also raise it in our party platform. But the issue should not be used to score a brownie point.
Issue should not be used to score any brownie points, Ripun Bora.
Yes, yes, I also agree that from the very beginning I am saying that I have not this issue, I have not raised this issue on political.
Okay, fair enough. The audio quality is bad. Asomi Dr. Barua, I mean, nobody should score brownie points, there is no doubt about that. But as you said, I want a little elaboration. Do you think it can lead to more other things than the national anthem issue is one? Do you think we have enough other issues to work fight together jointly?
Obviously, that goes without saying. But Wasbir, this could be the stepping stone to the greater unity of Northeast, as we've been talking, cutting across party lines. And I think our voices should be reached or heard beyond this region. It's an extremely good move of at least Northeast Live, who's actually taken up the topic, and this is being discussed and argued, and at least more people are now listening to it or voicing their opinions. But I think we should take this discourse to a larger space and have the national media and people across the country, from Sindh to, you know, Dravid, to all the names that have been placed there in that beautiful national anthem of ours. We should actually take this discourse to every corner of India and let all of them understand that this is an important issue for one huge population of India who actually rightfully belong to the greater nation.
Absolutely.
And who feel left out, and so include us and help us be included. I think that is very important.
That very well said, Ahmed Dr. Barua there. Let me try if I can go back to Jarpom Gamlin there. Okay, I think we have lost the connection. Mohir Bora, I mean, is there a case for all the Northeastern state governments now to pitch in?
See, Wasbir, I am an optimist, but I am also a pragmatic man, so I don't believe in all the issues concerning.
So, at the end of the day, you are saying that
I am not a pessimist. Yeah, real politics will come, because I am not an astrologer. I am not a paid man who will be saying, dissing out optimism just like that, right, left and center.
Mm-hmm.
I say, in any of the important issue like this again, I say, this is a symbolic issue, but highly important. So, symbolic and substantive, both kind of important issues, when all the people of Northeast are likely to be affected and likely to be influenced. I think Congress and BJP, being the two major parties, they should be on the same page in the larger interest of the larger genuine interest of the people of Northeast, because enough water has flown over all the rivers of Northeast, including our very dear Brahmaputra. So I think time has come to translate those rhetoric into reality now.
Yes.
Turn rhetorics to reality. Yes, I think Jarpom Gamling is there. Now, Jarpom, my question to you, now, will you will you also see your party? You are with the BJP. Your party is in power in Arunachal Pradesh. Your party is also in power at the center. My question to you: will you pitch in to this demand for inclusion of the Northeast in the national anthem through the Arunachal government? Are you going to request the Arunachal government to formally move the center on this?
बिल्कुल आई थिंक फिलोसॉफिकली एक दिशा के हिसाब से आप जो कह रहे हैं बिल्कुल सही है कि पूर्वोत्तर को इंक्लूड करना चाहिए, मगर ये स्पेसिफिक डिटेल कैन बी वर्कड आउट, एक उनका जो डिटेलिंग हो सकता है बाद में, मगर एक आइडिया के हिसाब से बहुत बढ़िया आइडिया है जो मेरे ख्याल से किसी भी पूर्वोत्तर राज्य में कोई भी सरकार हो किसी को कोई आपत्ति नहीं होनी चाहिए। मगर मैं फिर से दोहराऊंगा कि पहले जो कहा है कि सिंध को हटा के कि पूर्वोत्तर का लगाए, ये नहीं होना चाहिए। किसी अगर आपने आगे बढ़ना है तो आप आगे बढ़िए, उसका मतलब ये नहीं कि आप किसी को हटाओ या किसी को आप नीचा दिखा के आगे जाओ, किसी को खींच के नीचे करके आप आगे जाओ। मगर मैं ये मानता हूँ कि वो सिंध को रहने दीजिए, बिकॉज सिंध नदी आज भी देश का अभिन्न हिस्सा है और कल भी रहेगा। मगर पूर्वोत्तर भी कल भी था, आज भी है, कल भी रहेंगे। मगर मेरा ये कहना है कि पूर्वोत्तर में आज भी कुछ ऐसे जनजाति है, कुछ ऐसे प्रदेश है जो भारत के अभिन्न हिस्सा नहीं रहना चाहते, लेकिन उनको भी साथ में लेना है तो ये एक अच्छा दिशा होगा और इसमें किसी भी राजनीतिक दल को कोई आपत्ति नहीं होनी चाहिए और उसमें हमारे जो पेमा खांडू सरकार है उसमें उनको भी कोई आपत्ति नहीं होगी।
एब्सोल्युटली वेरी क्लियर कट स्टेटमेंट देयर, सिंध को रहना चाहिए लेकिन पूर्वोत्तर को भी इंक्लूड करना है, सो दैट इज व्हाट जारपुम गामलिन इज सेइंग। रिपुन बोरा, योर लास्ट वर्ड्स, वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम नाउ।
I have already said that my first duty is how to improve the name of
that is my top priority. So so far the thing is concerned, my only point is that at this present context it is not relevant, because entire scene it is in Pakistan, nowhere it is connected with the sentiment of the people of India
yes.
at present. So, in this present context, I am saying that seems to be delayed.
Absolutely. Siddharth Bhattacharjee, very last words.
Right at the beginning, I have said that the national anthem, it's a symbol of our Indianness.
Yeah.
And people, the new concept of Uttar Purb, definitely it also represents a substantial number of population of Indian citizens.
Yeah.
So if the word is included, I feel it will be good and
Absolutely.
It will lead to more inclusiveness in our area.
Lead to more inclusiveness, Moyer?
I think Professor Udayan Mishra's words that periphery strikes back, I think this kind of inclusive paradigm, if we can, or narrative, if we can bring about in the political discourse of the country, I think periphery will not be striking back. Periphery will try to cooperate with the so-called major mainstream
periphery
India to see a very developed new India as has been propounded time and again by the Honorable Prime Minister.
Periphery may move closer to the mainstream in
yes.
that kind of a scenario. Ahome Dr. Borua, last word.
Yes, I absolutely agree with the other speakers on the panel today. I mean, it goes without saying that obviously what all of us want is for the greater good of the entire country.
Absolutely.
It's not about a specific region alone. When you remove one part of the country from the discourse, you don't have a cohesive whole. You know, so this is a very good step. And I think if this begins like this, then there will be a lot of other issues,
Very
other
true.
Things which we can push from our side.
Very true.
Yeah.
It's one of those rare occasions we see convergence, not just among political leaders belonging to different political parties, but also civil society voices who are otherwise also very, very divergent. On that note, we'll end this edition of Northeast Tonight. I thank all my panelists. Good night and goodbye.